developer, so hope you're doing well. So in this video, I will tell you how to create navigation drawer, how easy it is to set up a navigation drawer with the help of navigation component. Okay, just go to your layout file, click on design, search for navigation view, just drop it to your layout. Click on code part. So if you use navigation view before, so you must know we need to add a drawer layout as well. Just copy these properties from here and paste it to your drawer layout. Your content and move it to drawer layout. Just drag out navigation view to your drawer layout and just format the code. Remove duplicate lines. Assign ID to your drawer layout will be drawer underscore layout and it should be navigation underscore. Okay, so we have a navigation view, we have drawer layout. Next thing will be we need to link a menu file to it. So I have already created this menu file for you. It will be navigation menu. Key point here is, so whenever you will create a navigation view with the help of navigation controller, so each menu item should have a same ID which you have assigned to a navigation graph. So screen 2 has an ID of screen 2, screen 3 have an ID of screen 3, and screen 1 have an ID of screen 1. Okay, so we have our layout setup. Next thing will be, just go to your code and link this navigation view to your layout. Just create a function called setup navigation drawer. So if you watch my previous video where I have tell you how we can set up a toolbar and perform an action with the help of navigation component, similar way we follow the same approach here. Initially find your nav host fragment, call it support fragment manager dot find fragment by ID, and its ID will be fragment container view. I've cast it to nav host fragment. Next, we need to get a navigation controller. It will be nav host fragment dot navigation controller. Okay. Next task will be link this navigation controller to our navigation view. We have dot navigation view dot setup with navigation controller, and it will take navigation controller. So we have our layout file and we have set up a navigation drawer. Let's see if it works or not. If you see here, your navigation view appear top of your container. So we need to make some changes to our layout. Just add a layout gravity of layout gravity and its gravity will be start. Okay, let's refresh the UI again. Now you see we have a container, and whenever user slide, we have our navigation view with these three menu items. So whenever I click on screen 3, so we navigate to screen 3. User click on screen 2, user navigate to screen 2. But next thing will be, I need to show a toolbar to a user with a hamburger icon. So how I can do this part? So initially you need to set up action bar here. So we got set support action bar and it will be your toolbar. Okay, now we have set up a toolbar. Let's see how it works. Okay, now we have a toolbar, but still we don't able to see hamburger icon. Let's see how we can set up. So we need to create a app bar configuration. App bar configuration will take a navigation graph, so we can get a navigation graph. Next will be your drawer layout. So we have a drawer layout. We need to link this app bar configuration to our toolbar. We call toolbar dot setup with a navigation controller, and it will be navigation control, and we need to pass app bar configuration. Okay, now see, we have our hamburger icon. Okay, whenever user click on it, navigation drawer open. So next task will be, let's say whenever user click on screen 3, I want to hide a toolbar. Okay, so how we can achieve this? So we will call navigation controller dot add on destination change listener. So create a property called object, and it will give you suggestions on destination change listener. Okay, implement members on destination chain. So whenever my destination chain, if destinations dot id equals to, let's say r dot id dot screen one fragment, then I need to hide toolbar. So I will say toolbar dot set visibility gone. Otherwise, toolbar is equal to view dot visible. Let's see if it works. Initially, we have a screen one fragment and we have added a condition like when our ID will be screen one fragment, then we need to hide a toolbar and just go here, click on screen three. If you notice here, the toolbar comes back. Now again, go to screen one, there is toolbar hides. We have this back arrow, but instead of back arrow, I want to show a hamburger icon. Okay, so how we can show this part? So instead of passing a graph, I will define a set of IDs for which I need to see a hamburger icon. Okay, I say for screen one fragment and for screen two fragment, I want to show hamburger icon, and for other, I want to show a back arrow. Okay, just remove this code for now. We don't need this code. Just run the code. Okay, now click on screen two. We have this hamburger icon. Now click on screen three. Okay, now we have this back arrow. Now again click on screen 1, so we have hamburger. Click on screen 2, we have hamburger again. So this way you can update a UI whenever you need to show a hamburger icon and whenever you need to show a back arrow.